The SpaceX Falcon Heavy has flown before, but now it's got a payload that matters, and competitors nipping at its heels. The second flight of the most powerful rocket in operation is just days away. SpaceX is targeting April 10th, Wednesday, for the next flight of its mega rocket, the Falcon Heavy, which will fly for the first time since its inaugural test last February 2018. The behemoth will lift off from historic Pad 39A at Kennedy Space Center, directly across the Indian River from downtown Titusville, Florida. It's the first of a new generation of launch vehicles that can take huge payloads to space cheaply and frequently, opening up a new frontier in the space race. This April 5th afternoon, a shiny new SpaceX Falcon Heavy roared to life as smoke billowed from its engines during a pre-flight test. The brief ignition, known as static fire test, is one of the last major milestones in launch preparations, this ensuring that all systems are working properly and that the rocket is ready to fly. This static fire went so well, so weather permitting, takeoff should take place as scheduled around 6:36 Wednesday evening. The SpaceX Falcon Heavy highly anticipated launch was initially scheduled for Sunday night, then delayed until Tuesday. A threat of severe weather has now pushed the launch to Wednesday. SpaceX CEO Elon Musk tweeted to explain why the Falcon Heavy's launch date is especially tentative. Static fire data looks good so far. This is the first launch of Falcon Heavy Block 5, so we're being extra cautious. Launch date might move. Air Force weather officials are predicting a 30% chance of good launch conditions on Tuesday. That's not great, but rockets have launched in worse conditions. The primary concern with weather on Tuesday will be clouds, rain, and lightning moving over the space coast during the launch window. SpaceX delays the launch to Wednesday, weather improves to an 80% chance. In this video, Engineering Today will discuss the second flight of the most powerful rocket of SpaceX Falcon Heavy. What's the big deal for SpaceX Falcon Heavy? What's Falcon Heavy launching? What should I expect to experience? So, let's get started. The SpaceX Falcon Heavy is scheduled to launch a large communication satellite, Arabsat-6A, built by Lockheed Martin, into orbit for the Saudi Arabian company Arabsat. The satellite is an advanced commercial communication satellite designed to provide internet communication services to residents of the Middle East, Africa, and parts of Europe. This Arabsat-6A was originally slated to launch in the third quarter of 2018, but the liftoff has slipped several months. The Block 5 rocket upgrade first debuted on SpaceX Falcon 9 and added higher thrust on all the engines, improved its landing legs, and streamlined the reusability of its first stage. But with a multi-million dollar payload on board, SpaceX is taking extra precautions to avoid any potential problems. Florida sees dozens of launches a year from Kennedy Space Center and Cape Canaveral Air Force Station. What makes the SpaceX Falcon Heavy launch a feast for the eyes and ears is its power at liftoff and the encore triple booster landing after launch. SpaceX completed 21 successful launches last year, becoming a crucial part of the infrastructure that puts satellites into orbit and sends supplies to the International Space Station. Plus, Falcon Heavy's maiden voyage went almost perfectly. SpaceX Falcon Heavy is the most powerful rocket flying today, but it has only one spaceflight under its belt so far. The reusable rocket's one and only flight took place during February 6th of last year, ferrying Elon Musk's now infamous cherry red Tesla Roadster, driven by a spacesuit-wearing dummy named Starman, into an elliptical orbit of Mars and Earth. That launch had the additional pizzazz of being the biggest rocket since the Saturn era ended in the 1970s. The nearly flawless first launch, where SpaceX successfully recovered its two side boosters, which simultaneously touched back down to Earth like a kind of choreographed rocket routine. But the main booster botched its landing on a drone ship and crashed in the Atlantic Ocean, which Musk said was due to some of its return engines failing to ignite during re-entry. April 10th will be SpaceX Falcon Heavy's next opportunity to prove that its massive lift power is on track to begin tackling significantly more ambitious commercial space missions. Why exactly is SpaceX Falcon Heavy important? After all, Launch vehicles capable of putting 100 tons of material into or beyond orbit have existed since Apollo. Simply speaking, the difference comes down to price. Putting anything into space is difficult enough, but heavier payloads get exponentially more difficult to lift. As advances in materials and rocket engines have progressed, they have disproportionately benefited small and medium launch vehicles. Combined with the decreasing size of satellite payloads, this has created a new and promising era for small craft, which can be launched in great numbers, as we're seeing in the many promises to deploy constellations thousands strong. Efficiently made disposables like Rocket Lab's Electron and reusable ones like the Falcon 9 have begun the process of pushing the price of small and medium-sized launches down to a fraction of what they once were. But heavy and super heavy launch vehicles have remained phenomenally expensive due to the fundamentally difficult nature of building these physics-defying monsters. So while putting 10 tons in orbit has gotten cheap enough that startups can do it, putting 100 tons up there remains the province of global superpowers. SpaceX Falcon Heavy is really the first to start a similar price shift for this category, cutting the cost of putting large payloads up by a huge amount. And while an estimated price between $90 million and $150 million per launch is hardly pocket change, it's a whole lot less than the $350 to $500 million a Delta IV might cost. SpaceX Falcon Heavy has already been certified by the US Air Force to fly national security payloads. SpaceX has even snagged a military mission for the rocket, a $130 million deal to launch an Air Force Space Command satellite. The black and white Colossus combines three Falcon 9 first stages to form one 27-engine mega rocket. There are 9 engines each in the first stage center core and 2 Falcon 9 boosters strapped to its side. The souped-up Falcon 9, dubbed the Block 5, packs a much bigger punch. For comparison, SpaceX's smaller rocket, the Falcon 9, has 1 booster, 9 Merlin engines, and can generate more than 1.8 million pounds of thrust. The first launch did not fully test Falcon Heavy's full power at liftoff. This second launch is expected to be even more powerful, according to SpaceX CEO Elon Musk. He pointed out on Twitter that the Falcon Heavy that flies this week could feature more than 5 million pounds of thrust, roughly a 10% more thrust capacity than before, which also translates to a better safety margin if using less than its maximum. Onlookers got a taste of that increased performance on April 5th, as the rocket's 27 first-stage engines fired in unison for a few seconds. In addition to the added thrust, the Block 5 Falcon 9 features myriad upgrades designed to facilitate reusability. Previous versions of the SpaceX Falcon 9 were designed to only fly 2 to 3 times. The Block 5 is capable of flying as many as 10 times, with little to no refurbishment in between flights, Musk has said. SpaceX Falcon Heavy is expected to launch at 6:36 p.m. Wednesday. If all goes according to plan, the two side boosters will touch down in unison on their designated landing pad at Cape Canaveral Air Force Station, while the central booster will land at sea on one of the company's 2 drone ships. SpaceX Falcon Heavy has little competition at payloads above the 50-ton threshold, but below that, the field is getting crowded. ULA, Ariane Group, Russia, and China, even upstart rival Blue Origin, are preparing cheaper next-generation platforms to take part in the new ecosystem. SpaceX's long-term goal is to get organizations, including NASA but also private companies, to commission it to send probes to far-off corners of the solar system, or perhaps supplies to Mars. If conditions are prime and Falcon Heavy pulls a flawless launch, we should expect to see it fly much more often in the future. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting. And kindly provide your valuable feedback in the comment section. This will help us to improve.